Praise God. Are you excited today?
Yes.
Amen. I'm very excited. I'm always excited when God uses me for as a vessel to share the word of God. And I'm very excited that every Sunday God shows something wonderful, something interesting that you and I can learn and we can apply it during the week. It's very important that whatever you hear, the word of God, you must apply it also. Okay, it's just hearing it, you feel nice, that's good. But doing it, you feel even more better. Yeah? So, today my topic is Christian journey. Okay? The journey that God has blessed us with today. And the Bible calls journey as a pilgrimage. Okay? And today we're going to talk a little bit about that. We've got about 25 minutes, but we'll try and see how much we can cover. And I want to take you to Psalms 84, verse 5, 6, and 7. Psalms 84, verse 5, 6, 7. I'll read that for you. Blessed is the man whose strength is in you, whose heart is set on pilgrimage. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a spring. The rain also covers it with pools. They go from strength to strength. Each one appears before God in Zion. Amen. So I want to show you a perspective about this verse. First, let's understand the background as to why this kind of message is in Psalm 84. If you read ahead, you will also see, for a day in your court is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of God. So this psalm has been written by the Korahites. You know, if you read in, don't read now, you can write it down. If you see in 1 Chronicles chapter 9, 17, 1 Chronicles 26, 1, 19, I think it was that time that this psalm came out. And it was written that way. The Korahites are official gatekeepers of the tabernacle. You read the entire how God has allotted them to take care of the tabernacle, and they were doorkeepers. And they wrote this wonderful, that's why if you notice in 10, it says about, I'd rather be a doorkeeper. So you must, that's the reason why that doorkeeper word is there, because the person who's written this psalm, the Korahites, they were the official doorkeepers of the temple, keepers of the door of the tabernacle in the time of Moses. They were watchmen at the entrance of the Lord. They were appointed as guardians to the temple doors. So they long to serve God. They long to be in the presence of God. They were so desperate for God. They say, you know, we love to be here only at the doorkeeper. We don't want to go inside outside. We want to be there only, because it's great pleasure to serve the Lord. No matter what you get to do, or what work you get to do for the kingdom of God, or what work you do in the church, it's great to be in the presence of God. Hallelujah. And so, here he writes over here, blessed is the man whose strength is in you. What does that mean? Now, last time I spoke to you about promise, and I spoke to you about the journey. Remember? All of you? So when you quote any scripture, don't get happy with the promise first. First look at the effort that needs to be taken for that promise to be fulfilled. Are you getting what I'm saying? So over here, if you see, blessed is the man whose strength is in you, whose heart is set on pilgrimage. That is the journey. That is the effort. And once you put that effort, then it says, as they pass through the valley of Baca, who that man? Who? Whose strength is in the Lord. The man whose strength is in the Lord. Bible calls such man blessed. Such person blessed, not cursed. What is it?
Blessed.
Blessed. Because his strength is not in him. His strength is in the Lord. He doesn't depend on his abilities anymore. He doesn't depend on his experience. I've been 15 years in the Lord. I've been 40 years in the Lord. He doesn't depend on that experience. I'm qualified, you know, I'm higher above the others, I can deal with people much better than others. No, he doesn't depend on his abilities. He doesn't depend on him. But he depends on the on the Lord. And you know, and he says over here is that whose heart is set on pilgrimage. You know why his heart is set on pilgrimage? Because his strength is in the Lord. Anything he does, anything he thinks about, he always thinks about the kingdom of God. You know, and I want to tell you, a pilgrimage is a Christian's life journey. Our heart must be set on this. So there are three things that you must remember to identify about how my strength should be in the Lord. There are three things that can help you decide. And I'll quickly let you know those three things. One is Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5, 6. If you're a person that trusts in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, in all your ways acknowledging Him, and He will straighten your path. That means your strength is in the Lord. If you don't do Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5, 6, then don't keep talking about my strength is in God, my strength is in God, His grace is sufficient for me, my strength is. I told you 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 9, when Paul talks about His grace sufficient for me and His power is made perfect in weakness. It is not for any other reason. It is because Paul was persecuted. He was in tremendous pain. He was beaten up in tremendous pain. His body became very weak. That's when Jesus promised him, "Don't worry, Thane. My grace is sufficient for you." Hallelujah. So, you know, grace works when you start becoming less for God. In the sense, when you bring all your abilities to the flow, you completely surrender yourself to God and say, "Lord, you know what? I come to your presence. I'm nothing, Lord. You know, Lord, I can't do this anymore. I'm failing all the time, Lord." Do you understand sometimes why we fail? Why we don't get to experience what God has promised? Because you don't know how to trust God. 3, 5, 6, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do you understand what that means? All your heart. You know how important that is for God? Then anything less than all is a failure. Let me put it that way. Jesus said, He summed up all the laws and the Torahs, and He said everything is hung on two commandments. The first one is love the Lord with all. Just imagine you remove the all. You remove the all, you remove Jesus out of your life. That's it. You know how important that all is? Are you able to give all? Are there still problems, compromises, situations, storms in our lives that we fail to give all to Jesus? A song says, "I surrender all." You know what I mean? It's not easy. I'm not standing here and telling you it's easy. It's difficult. But how can you see breakthroughs in your life if you're not able to give all to God? How can you expect God to work a miracle in your life if you can't trust Him? Can you? You can't. So if I'm praying, "Lord, you know, I believe, Lord, you can do this." If the Lord can do it, then you will not do it. Simple as that. If I'm praying, example, I'm praying, "Lord, thank you, Lord, that you'll fix this. You'll fix this thing, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I trust you completely." So when I trust God completely, I will no longer worry about it anymore. Because Jesus is not worry. So if I trust God, should I worry? Question is that. If you trust God, should you be worried? And if you are worried, because you might say, "No, brother, we are human, we are flesh." So was Jesus. But he trusted in his God. He trusted in Father Abba. So if you trust in something, why are you worried about it? I don't understand. Sometimes some people don't even get sleep in the night. Some people are tensed up when they're traveling also. They're thinking about the problem. Why are you thinking? Have you not given it to Jesus? Have you not surrendered to Jesus? Then when you're traveling, why are you taking tension? You're crossing the road, you're thinking about that problem. What will happen? The next minute you see that you are in the hospital bed. It is not what, it's not the devil has done anything. You have messed it up. You have failed to trust God. I'm talking about Psalm 84 verse 5, friends. Blessed is the man whose strength is in him. It is not an easy verse, it's very difficult. Bible calls such man blessed. What more do you want? Hallelujah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are safe. How can I see this word getting real in my life? By me putting my entire strength in the Lord. My strength comes from the Lord. My strength is not mine. It is the Lord's. When I believe in Jesus, what happens? The power of God comes in my life through the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is upon my life. And we sang the song, right? The Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty. What an apt song. So if the Spirit of the Lord, what you sang, did you mean it? All of you? Are you only singing? Or you, do you really mean that's yours? It's like, you know, someone said, even if I sing somebody else's song, I will sing it in such a way that I am the writer of that song. It's coming from my heart. When God hears that song, God will say, wow. God will always, you know that this song, I think this guy has written it. It's amazing. He feels it. He really believes it. And if we say the Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty, then why are you worried? How many of you know that the Spirit of God is in you? You know, everybody? Now show me your hands. When you show your hands, no, that's faith. You know no Spirit of God is within you? Then ask yourself this question. You will have a mobile phone? You have a mobile phone? Take out the mobile phone. Take out the mobile phone. This is very interesting now. Mobile phone out, everybody, so slow you are, yeah. Come on. Quick. You have your mobile phone?
Yes.
Okay. You have a camera?
Yes.
Open. Don't look at, so go on selfie mode. You all know, no, very fond of selfie, no? Go on selfie mode. Everybody selfie mode? Don't take selfie, huh? I will tell you where to capture. But right now don't capture. Just go on selfie mode. Look your own self and talk to yourself. The Spirit of the Lord is great and mighty. Say. Don't look at me, look at your own photograph. The Spirit of the Lord, say loudly. So why am I not able to trust God? Say, ask yourself a question. Now close the selfie mode. Now put the phone back in the bag. Think about it. We are always struggling with this problem here. I don't know why. We need to get rid of this. We need to come out of this problem. When are you going to come out? When Jesus comes back? It's too late that time. Look, if you don't trust God, then you don't believe that God is powerful. If you trust God, then I know God is powerful. Because, you know, we heard testimonies today, how God has healed people, how God has brought miracles in people's life. You know why? Because they believe they trusted God. You know, generally what happens when the miracle happens, when people trust, when there is nothing more left, no options. Matlab, they look at the phone, even that Siri, no? Who talks back to you? Siri, huh? No options left, sorry. Now you can turn to God. It's almost like that. Until all your options get exhausted, then you become a desperate man. Now I have no choice. I better start kneeling down every day, fast and pray, and let me now ask God. This is our attitude. That is the reason why our heart is not set on pilgrimage. Pilgrimage, someone said this, not me, I read this somewhere, he said, pilgrimage is the Christian's life journey to the kingdom of God, or the way that God has set for us. What is it? It's a Christian life journey to the kingdom of heaven. God, the kingdom of heaven. So, till the time we meet Jesus, the journey that the day I accepted Christ into my life as my personal Lord and Savior, from that moment till the journey I'm going to see the Lord Jesus, that's your pilgrim life, that's your journey. So it says your heart should be set on pilgrimage. So what does pilgrimage mean now? It means the life that God wants you to live. It's a life dedicated to God. Jesus set his heart on pilgrimage. 3.5 years in the ministry, he left everything, he left his family, everything he left. He just stepped on because it was the right time for him at that point. What am I saying? Am I saying leave your jobs and everything and just focus on God? No. If you work, wherever you're working, your heart should be set on pilgrimage. Your heart should be set on the holy journey that God expects you to walk. Bible says, be holy as I am holy. So pilgrimage is a holy walk. A walk that is pleasing to God. Not only on Sundays, but every day. Not only at home, but in your workplace, in your business area, in your society, what people think about you. Oh, are you just here to please men and that's it? As long as they think good about me, I'm good about it. No. That's wrong. That's not pilgrimage. That is your own rules to walk life. Some people have this strange principles in their mind. It's my principle in life. What do you mean your principle? You have, it is God's principle. It has to be always God's principle. No. I want to do this. You want to do matlab what? It's not you. God. Does God want you to do it? No. I will do it. No, you will do fine, but does God want you to do it? I want to get promoted. You want to get promoted. Does God want you to get promoted? I want to take up this job, but does God want you to take up this job? I want to invest money here. I want to invest money. Hold on. Does God want you to invest money? Thinking about the kingdom. Thinking about God. Thinking about his principles. Thinking about the word of God. That is pilgrimage. That's a journey, which is a very tough journey. Matthew 22:14. Don't open your Bible. Just remember. Matthew 22:14. For many are invited, but few are chosen. Everybody cannot walk the pilgrim. You should know that also, by the way. Many are going to be left behind. Look at each other and say, not me. Not, don't say me, not me. Yes. Don't live a life of deception, friends. Stop fooling yourself. Stop fooling with God. And stop taking God for granted. So 3, 5, 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your own. That means you have to be a fool for God. You have to be a naive person for in front of God. Huh? Not front of people, in front of God. Lord, I humbly come before you, God. Are you humble enough? Are you humble enough? Lord, you know what? Whatever I am, whatever I do, Lord, but I humbly come to your throne of grace, God. Lord, I need you, Lord. I can't do anything without you. Jesus said, you can do nothing without me. I am the vine, you are the branch. If you want to bear fruit, you have to be engrafted with the Lord Jesus. You have to be connected with Jesus. And if you're walking in the way of the Lord Jesus, you cannot compromise anybody else's methodology in that walk. Okay, Jesus said, I've got to walk a holy life, I've got to walk a straight life, then I cannot accept bribe. No corruption. Nothing can cross my way because this is my way. Not my way, but the way God wants me to live. you know, lying to each other. That's bad. Living a life of sin, how long will you live? How long will you be successful? Keep living, no? You want to challenge God? You want to fight with God? Then keep sinning. See what happens. See what God will do. You know, God is a very loving God. He is full of mercy and compassion. His love endureth forever. But don't forget, he also gets angry. You don't want to see the anger of God. Stay away. To whom more is given, more is accounted. If you have accepted Christ in your life, He expects you to walk according to His word and live a life worthy for Christ. Not always thinking about your material life, my career. मैं किधर जाएगा 10 साल के बाद? ये सोचो, तुम यीशु के पास नहीं जाएगा तो किधर जाएगा? नरक में जाएगा, नरक में. You don't like to hear these words, no? Nerik is not inside the church, outside the church. That's a deception thought, be careful. To whom, when you know more, that means more is expected from you, no? Outside the church, people who don't know Christ, they don't know, no? They don't know. Because we don't want to tell them. But now we know everything. So now what God will expect from you? God says, if you know everything, then do know. मालूम है तो करो, नहीं करने का. Sometimes people do things for the Lord only when it's comfortable for them. I don't know why that thought has come inside your mind. Throw it in the garbage. Only if it's comfortable for me, I will do serve the Lord. Only if it's comfortable for me, I will take this extra time. Why are you thinking like that? Who made you think? I did not preach that message anytime. Whether you like it or not, whether you have time or you don't have time, whether you are comfortable or not comfortable, you still have to serve God. You still have to be faithful to God's work. You have to, right? Whether you are sick, whether there is boils in your body, whether there is anything that happens to you, you still have to love God. You still have to praise Him. You still have to lift His name higher. You still have to, you know, in front of other people, you have to lift the name of God higher and higher. Why? Why? Because it's my decision to follow Christ. Why? Because my temperature, my thermometer doesn't go up and down because of these problems. It's always constant. Why? Because my God is a faithful God. God is a good God. So what are you going to do? Walk the pilgrim. Your heart should be set. For your heart to be set, first of all, your strength should be in the Lord. Otherwise, your heart can never be set up, pilgrim. Number two. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. You know it by heart? But before that, there's a verse. Let's open. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 1 and 2, and I'm reading it. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which is so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Amen. Was it only for Paul? Is it only because Paul wrote the, are ye to kisne likha? Paul ne likha. Ye Paul ke liye. Apne log ke liye, baba. Hum log to seedha saadha log. Common man. Common log hai. Bada nahi hum Paul ke to. Anointed. Everybody says that. Are ye to bahut anointed hai. You know what happened to you? Tum kabhi less anointing ho gaya. No, people don't want to accept only God's power in their life. Matlab, you are so stubborn. You are so stubborn. Dekho, accept karna hi nahi hai kya anointed. No, he is more anointed. More. You also are anointed of God, no? Why? Because God chose you. You are special. Say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You say, I am special.
I am special.
So what are you going to do if you are special? Believe that God will work through your life, but you got to get it right. Bible says the anointing shall break every yoke upon your life. Hallelujah. Christians are not supposed to be struggling. You know why you struggle in the world? Because you're struggling in the world. That's why you're struggling in the world. And if you think you're successful in the world, then think twice. I'm successful in the world because I'm successful in the world. See the deception. Okay, if you're successful in the world, then do you trust God completely? Question comes back to you. Do I trust God in everything? No matter what happens, do I trust Him? And so we need to look into our life. Hebrews 12:1 says, endure the race that is set before us. Number 2, verse 2. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him, endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Amen. And this is what God is expecting us. We need to look straight, endure, have the endurance to walk. Even if something goes wrong in your family, in your life, don't stop praying. Don't stop reading God's word. Don't stop walking according to the word that God has set before us. I'm saying the yardstick is same for all of us, including me. The yardstick is the word of God. We must develop a habit of reading God's word every day. And not only that, when you read God's word, you have to meditate, you have to think full day. It should be chewing. You need chewing like how you chew the gum. Full day it has to, you have to remember what you read in the morning. That is the biggest victory for your life. Just remembering what you read in the morning. First half of the day at work, okay, what I read. While you're eating your food, you pray, Lord bless this food, but I read this. Okay, having tea, I know what I read in the morning. Thank you, Lord. The devil cannot snatch away what the word that is in my heart. I thank you, Father, for reminding me. And before leaving to work, before you log out, again, what I read in the morning. People still forget what you read in the morning. You read in the morning, somebody asks you, brother, what you read? How can you forget? Those who seek after the Lord may not necessarily go back to the world. Hear this. Somebody said this, not me. Those who seek after the Lord may not necessarily go back to the world, but may unconsciously fall back to the fleshly mindset. So you are in the church very much. You will not physically go to do something, but your mind, instead of being spiritual, you are becoming carnal mind. You understand what I'm saying? Your mind has not yet changed. Your God has changed. You now believe in Jesus, but your mind has not changed. Your mindset has not changed. You're still thinking about the fleshly things. You still feel that for me the priority, brother, is material. For me the priority is first the physical aspects of life. Wrong! It's wrong! It's wrong. Your priority of your life should be spiritual mindset. You should think about the kingdom of God, my friends. You should think about the word of God. One day I spoke about your spiritual bio data. Everybody make one, bring it next Sunday. Anniversary time. I'll keep one box over there. Drop your resume in the box. Not your worldly work, spiritual. You understand what I'm saying? Only don't put your name. Leave the name. I want to know name. I want people to know. You can make your spiritual biodata, all of you. What is spiritual biodata? Huh? How many years experience in spiritual warfare? How many years going to church? You want to say?
We all.
But I'm saying you make your spiritual violator. I'll send it once to you. Everybody fill it up. Take a printout, nice printout, and submit it down. You will know exactly where you're standing in the kingdom of God. One more line in that spiritual violator. How many souls have you? Your favorite. It's your favorite. How many? Not eaten. Saved. Okay, you can't save, right? Only the Spirit of God can save. How many seeds you have sown? How many people you have told about Christ? We'll start from 2018 and we'll end in 2019. Don't wait till end of the year. Everybody waits end of the year. Oh, pura saal gaya, kuch nahi kiya. Ye same dialogue 5 saal se bol rahe aap. Arey kuch karega ye saal, kuch karega. Prabhu ke liye karega. Kya karega? Another promotion comes, gaya. 8 months, lock-in period. Lord, let 8 months get over, then I will run for you. You don't know which direction, but I'll run. God is so sweet, no? God will say, yeah, my child, yeah, give him the promotion. He's sweet, God. But we are not that sweet when it comes to returning back to God. So, we got to look unto Jesus, the author and perfecter, if you want to walk the pilgrim way, your journey. Otherwise, you will never be successful. Many people look at people and walk the journey. Many people look at other people's faith and walk the journey. Many people look at, instead of Word of God, they look at other magazines, spiritual man, walk the journey. I said, nahi hota. You have to read the Word of God. There is no replacement with this Bible book, Bible. There is no replacement. You have to read this word every day. The word is the light to my?
The lamp to my feet.
A lamp to my feet and light from my path. You want direction in life? I can tell you only one thing. Read the Bible. The Bible kaun padega? Aap aise shortcut mein padho. Shortcut mein kya? Padho those Bible or kya? Because the word of God is direction for you, right? You don't need a man to help you in that. You read God's word regularly, faithfully, every day, no? I am telling you, God will show you a direction. I can challenge you. But you read every day. You come late from work, you are tired. You don't miss sleep, but you will miss word of God. Nee, pehle sone ka. Soega nahi, the doctor bola bimar ho jayega. To sone ka. Arey, bimar ko chodo. Your spirit life is gone. How many days have gone which you said, I'm tired. Oh, I'm working too much. You don't read the word of God. You don't open. You don't make any efforts. You need to open the word of God. You need to read God's word, right? When the last time you sang a love song to Jesus? Last time. Not heard, huh? Everybody hears songs. Gospel song, Bollywood song. Udhar sab, kya bolte usko, khichdi ho gaya udhar. Praise gana bhi, Bollywood gana bhi, praise gana bhi, Bollywood gana bhi. Sab khichdi ho gaya, sab khichdi. You know what khichdi, na? Say. How much time you read God's word, how much time you watch television? Compromise. Because it's going to read God's word. How to read, brother? How? That is what I will teach you how to read. Open the Bible, open a chapter, read. No, brother, when I read God's word, I find I get good sleep after that. Good. But read. Don't sleep while you're reading. Compromise. Don't compromise. How can your strength be in the Lord if you're behaving like that? What kind of behavior is this? It's not a good behavior. As Christians, we need to be disciplined, my friends. Because the Spirit of God is in you and me. You and me. Don't mess with the Spirit of God. It's very powerful. It's very powerful. But you need to be disciplined, no? To receive what God wants to give you. Fix your eyes on Jesus. What you must do? Sometimes in the pilgrim journey, you must decide that I'll take 2 days off from work. Why? Your boss will say, why? Why? Because I have to leave, so I want to take orders from. But still be boss, some bosses, they will, nahi yaar, kyun nahi, bol. Reason, reason. Sometimes you tell, no, you took 2 days before what? I want to sit and pray for 2 days. Have you thought about that? I want to spend full time for God. Full time. 2 days. Everybody's thinking fasting, praying, fasting, praying, fasting, praying. You know what is fasting? Fasting is abstaining from something you like. 1 week don't watch TV. TV shut. 1 week? What? Next week only I'm buying a new TV. No, you buy. There is no problem. Buy. Because you can hear, you can watch Christian movies, gospel songs, buy a pen drive. So many good things you can do. You know? 1 week, just stay away from TV. Can we do that? I know I can see your face. And here we are talking about strength in the Lord, walk the pilgrim way, heart is set and all that. Stay away from these things, you know, for a while. Tell the Lord, Lord, I can do without it. It's not important. Jesus fasted for 40 days, by the way. But remember, after that, his life was completely abstained from the things of the world. He focused on what God had called him for. The purpose what God has called him for. And he walked the pilgrim way. He prayed for people. He healed people. He preached the word of God. He gave hope for the hopeless. He gave sight to the blind. He healed every sickness. Bible says sickness and disease. Every sickness and disease, Jesus healed. Why? Because of his surrender. Because of his sacrifice. Why do you expect great things from God when you can't do the basic? I expect great things from God. I expect, what do you mean expect? And don't learn to thank God, Lord, I will do away with this. I will not do it. Sometimes do it, no? Take this pilgrimage seriously, friends. What is pilgrimage? A journey for Christ. What is pilgrimage? Your willingness to sacrifice. It's like to draw close to Him, to seek Him, wait on Him, just be with Him. Sometimes, you know what? If you can't pray at home and there is some problem, you want to spend more time with God, go outside Bombay somewhere. Book one room with no TV. And no AC also. Lord, I want to be like this. And check through whether you can survive. Sorry, I used the word survive. Khana khao. But not so much. Just a little bit. Because you are going on pilgrim, no? Should not be greedy also. Little bit dal rice. Nay, regular chicken bhi chalega thoda bahut. Taste. Ke wo bhi will not taste. But go just by yourself. Just kneel on full day, pray, sing praises to God, meditate on God's word. I'm telling you that 2 days will be a life-changing experience for you. Now I said 2 days, it can be 3 days, 4 days, or whatever you convene for you, depending on your leaves at an office. Sometimes go, no? Sometimes, in a year. Not every day. Just in a year. Chalo, once in 2 years, that much you can think, no? Utna dil hai tumhara Prabhu ke liye, na? प्रभु को दिल देगा देखते क्या होता है. वंस इन थ्री इयर्स कैन यू गो द पिलग्रिम जर्नी? वंस इन थ्री इयर्स गो नो. कॉल मी एंड टेल मी व्हेन आई कम टू चर्च. ब्रदर आई एम गोइंग पिलग्रिमेज. गुड, गो. थैंक यू फॉर इनफॉर्मिंग. दैट्स ओके, यू कैन गो. यू मस्ट डू इट. हाउ विल यू कम क्लोजर टू द लॉर्ड? हाउ कैन यू टेस्ट योर सेल्फ that you are made of steel for God? God, and nothing will shake me. You know, when the storms come, when the earthquake comes and the problem comes in your life, you will never falter. You will never fall. Why? Because your heart is set on pilgrim. God will bring people in your life. Remember this. God will bring people in your life to mistreat you, to insult you. Take this as a blessing from God. Why? Because your strength is in God. The Bible says, even though you walk through the valley of Baca, Baca is the valley of weeping. Bible says that when you trust in God, when your strength is in God, when your heart is set on pilgrim, matlab your spiritual walk is so disciplined that you're not compromising, you're not taking anything
granted for God at work, at society, in your personal life, in your family life. You are just focused on God. Fix your eyes on Jesus. You're focused on God. You're focused on God. What will happen? Even if you walk through the valley where there's bitterness, God will change that into sweetness. You'll be such a miracle person for God that wherever you go, He will turn your sorrows into joy. Hallelujah! What is tears for you? But when you walk the pilgrim way, that tears will no longer be bitter. God will bring sweet waters in your life. Even though you walk the valley of back out this over here, what do you say in the next verse? He'll make it springs of pools. You'll find pools all over. Your life will be blessed. And so what we got to do? We have to learn and have the willingness to walk humbly with God. So when you walk humbly with God, all your pride, your ego, your problems, just put it away. Number three, I'll end over here. It says over here, Romans 12, 1, 2. So I said one is Proverbs 3, 5, 6. How do you have strength in God and God only? Proverbs 3, 5, 6. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. What it says? Do not be. What is the first verse? And therefore, I beseech you, brethren, to offer your bodies as living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. Look at this. Your journey has to be that way. Living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. Nothing is more important to you than the Word of God. Nothing is more important to you than Jesus. Everything is secondary in my life. I never hurt God to please man. I will never do that. Hallelujah. I will encourage you, church. Find your strength in God. You will be able to overcome a lot of things in life. And if you don't believe me, at least start trusting. Then you will see how your life and your problems will start changing. Amen. Let's just pray. Father, we thank you and bless you for this time, Lord. Even as we have come in your presence today, Lord, we thank you for speaking to us, Lord God. We pray, O Master, in Jesus' name, help us to trust you with all our heart, O Lord. Help us not to give 99%, but 100% trust to God. Help teach us, O Lord, how not to think about the things of the world above you, Lord God. Help us, Lord, to remove the fleshly mindset and help us to have a spiritual mindset, O God. Help us, Lord, your word says, the word I've spoken to you is spirit and life, Lord. Let your word be in our lives, Lord. Let us be walking in the spirit, Lord, because your word is in our life, Lord God. Help us, Lord, to have our strength, to put our strength in you, Lord God. You said, blessed is that man, O God. We want to be blessed, O God. And we want our heart to be set on spiritual things, Lord. On pilgrimage, Lord. We want our heart to be set on what you want us to live a life which is holy and pleasing to God. Even if that has to be sacrificing things of the world, Lord. We want to give you the best, O Lord God. Father, teach us, O Lord, how to really walk that journey, O Lord God. And then we know that when we walk through the valley of Baca, you will turn it into springs, O Lord God. You'll turn our sorrows into joy, O Lord. And we'll go from strength to strength, O Master. Thank you, Lord, for bringing every family to church. Even so many other families who have missed today, I pray that you'll minister to them, Lord. Lord, let your word continue to be in our lives. Even as we leave this hall, Lord, you speak to us, God. We just don't want to be the hearers of your word, but we want to be the doers, Lord God. Teach us, Lord, how to apply your word in our life. Help us to please you and not please ourselves and not please somebody else, Lord. Father, we want to worship and thank you for this time, for the worship, for the testimonies. You're doing wonders and miracles in the lives of your people. Lord, you're speaking through your people as well, Lord. Thank you for your presence this morning, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you, even as we leave from here, let your peace go with every family, Lord.
Father, we give you all the glory, honor, praise in Jesus' name. We make this prayer. Amen. Let's do a clap.